This episode is made possible in part by ABC Mouse.
To space and back.
With Jet Propulsion.
He showed up and now it's a blast. Looks like the future really got here fast.
Nice to meet you, human race. Tell me all about the place.
Jet Propulsion. Jet Propulsion. Jet Propulsion.
Ready, Jet Go!
Sean, Mindy, we've called you all over here because there's something funny going on that you Earthies may understand.
Oh, we sure don't.
All the houses in the neighborhood have changed lately.
Yeah, Jet's right. Look at the Petersen's place.
Yes, what are those things?
Pumpkins, fake spiderwebs, and a plastic bat.
But that's not all. At the supermarket today, everyone was buying all the candy. What on earth is happening?
There's a good explanation for all of this. Tonight is Halloween.
Halloween? What's that?
Ooh, I know what Halloween is. It's a holiday where you carve faces on pumpkins and turn them into jack-o'-lanterns. Dress up in a costume.
Go door-to-door and say trick-or-treat.
Collect as much candy as you can.
Get back home and eat the candy.
Yeah!
And last but not least, visit a haunted house.
Yeah!
A haunted house.
Ooh, sounds like fun.
Yeah, can't wait to find out what haunted means.
Ooh, let's go inside and figure out how to fix up our place so we'll fit in with the Earthies on this special holiday.
Great! I'm gonna do all the things on that list. But first, we have to make a list. Good. Sunspot already did. We'll do everything on this list, and it'll be the best Halloween ever!
Excelsior!
Oh, I almost forgot. One more thing. On Halloween, if a full moon rises, a witch flies across it on a broom.
Really?
Yep, it's super spooky. But I'm not afraid, because I'll be with you guys tonight.
Wow. A witch is gonna fly across the moon tonight?
Right. A witch is...
I know what a witch is. I saw it in a movie one time. The Wizard of Something. No place like Earth. Dresses all in black. Huge pointy hat. Green skin. Right? But what's this flying Earth vehicle? This broom. A flying broom. What fascinating Earthy technology. I wonder what powers it. Anti-gravitating fluxinators?
I can't wait to see when a witch flies on a broom across the moon.
What? You guys, there's no witch on a broom flying across the moon. This stuff is all made up.
Mitchell, of course there's witches on brooms flying across the moon on Halloween.
Come on. Have you ever seen one?
Well, no. But that's what Halloween is all about. Witches and brooms
so,
and black hats.
So, who's right? Mindy or Mitchell? Do witches really fly on brooms?
I'm afraid that Mitchell is right.
Yeah, it is actually made up, but it is a cool idea.
Then how awesome would it be for Mindy to see a witch flying across the moon on a broom tonight? Oh, very interesting plan, Sunspot.
Well, tonight would be especially cool to see anything fly across the moon, since it's Halloween and it's gonna be a full moon.
I love everything about this amazing Earth holiday. It's even gonna happen on the night of a full moon. Woohoo!
I agree, Jet. This is gonna be cool and spooky. And spooky cool.
Yoo-hoo! Kids, it's time. time to carve the Earth produce into spooky faces.
Ah, glad you're here, kids. Whoa.
Yes, we're making this the best Halloween spooky house ever.
Cool!
So please explain the John-O-Lanterns again.
Actually, they're called jack-o'-lanterns.
Ah, right. jack-o'-lanterns. Anyway, I went to the store to purchase this Earth produce to carve into faces.
Okay.
Yeah, the pumpkins were all sold out.
These are even better. Let's do this.
Wonderful.
Ooh, excellent fake Earth insect webbing, Sunspot.
Ooh, and that's a terrific fake giant Earth insect. Soon we'll fit right in with the other houses. What else do we need?
Look at those jack-o'-lanterns, Cody. Everything that the Propulsion family does is strange. Just look at these. And now they're carving fruits and vegetables, but no pumpkins? And who hangs an ant from their house on Halloween? Just what is going on over there, Cody? Sometimes I wonder how dedicated a detective you are, Cody. Well, come on, Cody. It's time to get ready for Halloween.
There it is. This is so exciting. Not only is it Halloween, it's also a full moon.
Not only that, my mom just told me that tonight, between 8 and 9 o'clock, there's going to be a total eclipse of the moon. A lunar eclipse.
A lunar eclipse? Fantastic!
Wait, what's a lunar eclipse?
It means it'll get all super dark. Super dark? Ooh, that sounds super Halloween-y. But, why are we getting a lunar eclipse?
Yeah, what exactly is a lunar eclipse?
Is it happening right now?
Nope. The eclipse won't happen until 8 o'clock.
Why?
Okay, let's say this ping pong ball is the moon, and this tennis ball is the Earth, and this sunspot is the sun. So, as the Earth orbits around sunspot, this little ping pong ball, the moon, is orbiting around the Earth. And sometimes, the moon gets on the far side of the Earth, and it gets completely covered by the Earth's shadow.
Good try.
I think I get it.
Sunspot's right. We don't need a demonstration with ping pong balls. We can go see the real thing.
Go see the real thing? You mean...
Yep. We can fly to outer space and see this lunar eclipse for ourselves.
Cool. Wait, can't we just look up lunar eclipses online? I mean, it isn't happening right now. What will we actually see?
We can see the sun, the Earth, and the moon, all from the unique perspective of outer space.
Yes!
You ready? Hop in, kids!
Me and my big mouth. Let's go in outer space.
Sunspot! Halloween road trip!
Okay, I'll take you out to look at the moon, but let's hurry so we're back in time for your trick-or-treating.
It's actually called trick or
treat. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Doors are shut, engines on, everybody's in their place. Let's go into our game! Yeah!
All right, we're far enough out that we can see your sun, your planet Earth, and your moon.
So cool. These will be the before the eclipse pictures.
So, I still don't get it. How does this eclipse work?
Okay, Jet. Notice that sometimes the moon gets on the far side of the Earth and it gets completely covered by the Earth's shadow? What makes it a lunar eclipse is that the Earth blocks the sunlight that usually lights up the moon.
Oh! Wait, isn't that exactly how I explained it back in your yard? On Earth?
Yes, but it's so fun to look at the actual Earth and moon and sun from space.
You're right. It is fun. And I'm not even space-sick. Much.
I can see the Earth's shadow covering the moon. It may take a while to completely cover it.
Exactly, Sydney. The total lunar eclipse will be later tonight.
Is there an eclipse every Halloween?
Oh, nope. It's just a fun Halloween surprise tonight. The full moon should get all dark right when you're out trick-or-treating.
You mean trick-or-treating?
Oh, right. Wonderful Earth praise.
Oh, speaking of trick-or-treating, it's time to get back. We all have to get into our costumes.
Next stop, Boxwood Terrace.
Excelsior!
What do you think is the best costume for me this Halloween?
Pirate, no. Clown, too scary.
Ooh, Sherlock Holmes.
The greatest detective of all. Perfect for my Halloween plans.
Oh, wow. That was so cool to go look at the moon on Halloween night.
Yeah.
This is the best Earth Halloween. And my first Earth Halloween. Right. Wait till you see what Sunspot and I have planned.
What?
Yeah, what do you have planned?
Trust me, my earthy friends. It's only the best Halloween plan ever!
Have you ever looked up at the moon at night and wondered why it looks like it's changing shape? Sometimes it looks like it's full and round, and other times it's just a half circle. Sometimes it's not there at all. What's going on with that? Hi, I'm astronomer Amy Meinzer. I've got the moon right here in my hands. Well, okay, it's not really the moon, but you get the idea. The moon isn't really changing shape, of course. It's just a matter of your point of view. As the moon is traveling around the Earth is traveling around the sun at the same time. And that means different shadows are moving across the moon. That's what makes it look like it's changing shape. We call this the phases of the moon. The Earth travels around the sun once a year, and the moon is traveling around the Earth once a month.
As the moon travels around the Earth, we sometimes see the side that's lit up by the sun. And other times, when the moon's between the Earth and the sun, we're looking at the part that's in shadow. That's what makes it look like it's changing shape.
So the next time someone tells you you're just going through a phase, just ask them which one. Half, full, quarter, crescent, you get the idea. This is my kind of basketball.
Celery, I have an idea. Let's make the garage into our Halloween haunt house.
But Carrot, are you suggesting we let people in our garage where they can see all our alien stuff?
Yep.
Well, sounds good to me. But who would want to look at a pretend haunted garage?
Halloween. I love it, Cody. It's a detective's dream holiday. I can be in costume and go undercover. It is my perfect chance to solve 3 Propulsion family mysteries. Tonight's mysteries to solve are, why was Sunspot carrying a green alien head? Was Chet sitting in a small space saucer or a big clamshell? Why did Mr. and Mrs. Propulsion carve so many different vegetables but no pumpkins? This is a big case, Cody. Ready to start our Halloween investigation?
Good, me too. Aha, Stuffy Bear. I applaud your creative choice of costume, young, gifted Mindy.
Thanks, Sydney. I mean, the coolest Commander Cressida ever.
Wow,
Doctor.
Ta-da!
Jet, I'm not sure if it's the best idea for you to dress as an alien.
An alien? What? I thought I was an Earth cucumber. Hello, I'm Carrot and Celery's son, Cucumber.
Ooh. No, Jet, that's an alien costume.
Okay, I'm an alien. And I can check wear a costume off my greatest Halloween ever to-do list.
Actually, you probably can be an alien tonight, since it is Halloween.
Brilliant!
So now we just need Sean.
You mean Neil Armstrong? The first human to walk on the moon?
Wow!
Looking good, Mr. Astronaut.
Thanks, you guys.
Speaking of Neil, I am so excited that it's a full moon and a total lunar eclipse tonight.
Plus, my mom told me this. The moon will also look red tonight, but I'm not sure why.
Red?
A red moon? Another Halloween mystery.
And I will hope that a witch flies across the moon on a broom.
Me too, Stuffy Bear. Okay, Commander Cressida, Dr. Sunspot, Neil Strongarm, let's trick your treat!
Trick or treat!
I'm so excited you get to trick or treat with us tonight, Mindy. We'll have fun. Now, Jet, what's your secret plan with Sunspot? You can tell us.
It'll be worth the wait, Sydney.
Is that your secret plan, Sean?
No, this is my can't-fail scientific method formula to get the most candy in the least amount of time. T equals H plus C squared. Treats equals houses plus costume. And the better the costume, the more candy you get.
Want to know my plan? I just knock on the door and ask for candy.
Makes sense to me, Mindy.
Begin undercover Halloween. In costume, no one will recognize me.
Check! And the next item on my Halloween list, collect candy!
Let's do it! One, two,
trick-or-treat!
Ah, okay. We have a teddy bear, Commander Cressida. You dressed your butt up. Huh. Oh, hello, Neil Armstrong, sir. And, are you a cucumber?
I thought so, too. But actually, I'm an alien. I'm from Bortron 7. Our house is actually a spaceship. Our van turns into a flying saucer. And Sunspot is my Bortronian pet.
Well, have some Earth candy, son of neighbors. Bye.
Wow, Jet, you really can get away with being an alien all night.
Yes!
Hello to our first treat or trickers. Magic trick or mushy wet cereal treat?
Mr. Unknown Neighbor, who are you?
I'm Sherlock Holmes.
Welcome to you, Mr. Holmes.
I really love scary Halloween stuff. The scarier, the better.
By the way, anyone seen Sunspot?
Scary. Scarier, the better. Right, Sean?
Trick or treat!
Okay. These are all awesome costumes.
Dr. Rafferty, have you heard of Bortron 7? Well, that's where I'm from. I'm an alien from far away!
Ah, Bortron 7, right. Well, Jet, welcome to Earth. And soon you'll be able to see the total lunar eclipse.
Cool!
The sun, Earth, and moon form a straight line, and the Earth blocks the moon's light.
Its shadow does, right?
Exactly, Commander Cressida. Okay, now, as a parent, I insist that you all brush your teeth thoroughly after eating your candy tonight,
We will!
Mom, about the red moon, why does it turn red during a lunar eclipse?
Aha, I thought you'd never ask. You see, the color red goes through the atmosphere better than other colors, just like at sunset. So even when the Earth blocks most of the sun's light, the moon still has a reddish color.
Cool!
I agree. Enjoy the rare Halloween eclipse and red moon tonight. I will.
Trick or treat!
Oh, thanks for taking Mindy around tonight. She feels so grown up.
I really do. Thanks, Mom.
Bye, Dr. Melendez! Thanks!
Wow, so it's not a saucer, but some kind of cool toy? Didn't expect that. One mystery solved.
Trick or treat! Trick or treat!
Ooh, spot on, Commander Cressida. Uh-huh, great.
Wow, Bortron 7, really? I always wanted to meet an alien.
And here's an alien trick and treat for you. A Bortronian folk dance. Hi!
I really hope we see a flying witch tonight.
Oh, you never know with the full moon.
Yeah, and I'll be full of the most candy ever. But how did you do that?
It's Sunspot. We'll never know. Hi, Mitchell. Did I ever tell you I was an alien from Bortron 7?
You're really from there? How'd you get here? Do you speak alien?
Silly. It's a Halloween joke.
Oh.
So the green alien head is a part of Jet's costume.
Another mystery solved.
Okay, now I've done everything on my list except visit a haunted house.
Oh, haunted house? There's a weird but really awesome one right there.
Hey, the line goes to my house. How could that be?
Oh, no!
Why is it Valentine's Day stuff?
Boo! Happy Halloween!
It looks like they worked really hard on this. Can we act really scared?
Yeah! Oh, they were terrified.
Went to a haunted house. Check. And I did everything on my list. Yes!
Oh my gosh, I almost forgot. The eclipse is about to happen. Come on, guys.
Sunspot. It's go time.
Go time? Come on, you can tell us.
Okay, I need you to help bring Mitchell and Mindy to the treehouse. Tell them there will be something extra special about the moon tonight.
Wow!
Oh, it is red. The lunar eclipse is making the moon red.
So amazing. A real red moon.
Witch would fly across the moon. It would be perfect.
Ah, Mindy, there's no way that a witch...
Look! It's really happening! A witch on a broom? Wow! Told you, Mitchell! Look, the witch even has her kitty cat with her!
Halloween, my favorite earthy holiday! Yep, that looks like a witch, all right.
But how could that be? This is impossible.
We all saw it.
You have to believe, Mitchell.
A witch really rode her broom across the moon, and this was the best Halloween ever.
Right! The best ever!
Look, now it's just the cat flying on the broom.
Whoa, all that spinning's making me really dizzy. If you're gonna spin like that, make sure you do it in a safe, open space. Of course, another name for spinning is rotating. Hi, I'm astronomer Amy Meinzer, and today I'm playing the part of the Earth. The Earth makes a lot of complicated motions as it speeds through space. First, it's going around the sun once a year. That's its orbit. And in addition to orbiting, it's also spinning. Every 24 hours, the Earth spins around one time. And that's what gives us night and day. In the morning, we see the sun come up, and it appears to travel across the sky during the day before it sets. Of course, the sun's not really moving. It's just the Earth is rotating. You can imagine you're standing here on the surface of the Earth, and as the Earth turns, the sun is facing away from us and toward us. That's what gives us day and night. Not all planets rotate at the same speed. Some spin fast, and others are slow. Some even spin in the opposite direction from the Earth.
Venus takes 243 days to rotate around once.
That means night would last a really long time. Even though Jupiter's the biggest planet in our solar system, it's spinning the fastest. It only takes it about 10 hours to spin around once. It's rotating so fast that it's actually being squished a little bit, and it's no longer completely round. So the next time you're rotating with your friends and someone tells you it's time to come in and go to bed, just tell them you're on Venus time.